How's Mark talk?
Dr. Bashir says he will make a full recovery.
I'm glad to hear that. Mr. Worf, we've got a serious problem on our hands.
Gowron.
He seems hell-bent on continuing these offensives, regardless of the cost.
He is a stubborn and arrogant man.
That may be true, but I hope he's not a fool. He's risking the entire defense posture. Why can't he see that?
I suspect the Chancellor cannot see anything at the moment, except for one man.
You mean Martok?
The Chancellor sees him as a political threat. These attacks against the Dominion are designed to humiliate the General in the eyes of the Empire, to force him to endure defeat after defeat.
Are you telling me that this is a political vendetta?
It would not be the first time that a Klingon Chancellor put his own interests ahead of the greater good.
Something has to be done.
Agreed. And I do have a solution, but it will not be easy.
You do whatever it takes, Mr. Worf. Those Klingon ships out there are the only thing between us and the Breen. Gowron is risking the safety of the entire Alpha Quadrant, and he has to stop.
Understood. The warriors that are gathered here would not say this to you, but I will. You are squandering our ships and our lives on a petty act of vengeance.
There can be only one answer to that.
Worf, this is madness. The Empire. Worf! 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 Worf!
Wait.
Worf!
Hear me.
Worf!
Hear me! What I have done was for the Empire. A new day must dawn for our people. I am not the man to usher in that day. But there is a man here who can.
Worf. I do not seek leadership.
Kalas said, great men do not seek power. They have power thrust upon them. Hail Martok, leader of the Empire, leader of destiny.
Something has to be done.
Understood. Great men do not seek power. They have power thrust upon them. Hail Martok, leader of the Empire, leader of destiny.